beginning our review of class. Consider a situation where a projectile leaves some platform, cliff, or whatever with an initial velocity V naught, and with V naught being horizontal, meaning that there's no y coordinate, no y component to the initial velocity. Now let delta y be the vector from here down to here, and let delta x be the vector from here to here, where this point is the point at which the projectile is going to land. Then there are three parameters here. There's V naught, there's delta y, and there's delta x. And these three are related in that if you know any two of them, you can find the third. If you know V naught and delta y, we know how fast the projectile is going here and how high this is, then we can predict where it's going to land. That would allow us to determine our delta x vector. If we know delta x and delta y, then we can determine V naught. And if we know V naught and delta x, our initial velocity, how far we traveled, we can determine what our delta y is. Now this is assuming an ideal projectile. The acceleration is always g in the downward direction. Now for any ideal projectile, where we don't have any air resistance or anything, the acceleration vector is just negative gj. That's what I just said, the acceleration is always simply g in the negative y direction. Integrating this acceleration vector, we get our velocity vector. Now, we've worked through this. I'm not going through all the details of this. We have 0i minus gj. I didn't write the 0i, but that has to be integrated, and that's going to give us a constant times I, and that constant can be identified with the initial x velocity in most applications. And then integrating g, we get negative gt plus a constant. The constant turns out to be the y velocity at t equals 0. So the constant we get for I is the initial x velocity, and the constant we get for y is the initial y velocity, the t equals 0 x and y velocities. Then the r vector is an integral of this. We're going to get v naught x t. We'll get an integration constant. In the situation we have here, I've sketched my x and y axes. The origin is here. The initial point of the projectile occurs when x equals 0. That would be identified with the integration constant, so I've implicitly just left that off. Purpose here isn't to show how to integrate these, just reviewing where they come from. And integrating the negative gt plus v naught y, this is what we get, and then our integration constant will be identified with the y position at t equals 0, so we're going to call that y naught. Now, if we're given delta y and delta x, that's the situation we have. If we run a projectile off the edge of the off a ramp off the edge of the table. So if we know delta y and delta x, how do we solve this problem? Of course, we can break it down into here's your y components and here's your x components, but we're trying to achieve a more general picture where we're dealing with the r, v, and a vectors. So assuming our initial r vector is 0 delta y, which simply means that, I wrote that as 0 comma delta y with an arrow over it, rather than 0i plus delta yj, just to save space. Clearly, that's this position here. 0i means none of this. Delta yj means we're up here. Now, v naught x, v naught y, and y naught. What do we know? We're just listing the parameters. So the remaining parameters are our parameters are these, and we need to see what we know about these. Well, v0x is what? That's the initial x velocity. That's just our velocity v0, the magnitude of our v0 vector. So v0x is just v0. V0y is 0 because we said that the initial velocity is horizontal. Now, shortly we do an example where that's not the case, but right now that's what we have. And y naught equals delta y. Our initial y position is just equal to the magnitude of the delta y vector. With that information, r of t, which equals v naught x I plus the negative gt squared plus v naught t and y naught, we can write the v naught x as v naught, the negative 1/2 gt squared plus delta y. Well, v naught y is 0, so we have no t term here, and that is simply the result of the initial velocity being in the horizontal direction. Okay, so delta x then is the x coordinate when the y coordinate is 0. And that should be obvious from the picture. The y coordinate is 0 here, and that's where the projectile is at a distance delta x, or at a displacement delta x from the origin. So, we're interested in the condition for which this projectile strikes the ground. Well, the projectile strikes the ground when r of t equals v0xt, which is the displacement in the x direction, plus 0j, because it strikes the ground when y is 0. And that has to equal this r of t function, v naught ti plus negative 1/2 gt squared plus delta yj. Setting these two equal, we get an equation, a vector equation, for the time when the projectile strikes the ground. Okay, the vector equation we saw just a minute ago before I flipped out the boards without warning. The r of t is v naught x t I plus 0j, and that occurs when the negative 1/2 gt squared plus delta y equals 0. I haven't written out both of the equations, but this is the I coordinate of a general point on the projectile, on the trajectory, and v naught xt is the x coordinate. Okay, so when the j coordinate is 0, this has to be 0, and we solve that and we get t equals plus or minus 2 squared of delta t delta y over g. Don't need to read that to you. Plugging that in for r, we get v naught xt becomes v naught x times this solution for t times I plus 0j. And that's going to be, well, just v naught x times this times I. And that's got to equal delta x times I, because the condition is, again, when the j component is 0, this is 0. This all leads to this and tells us that delta x is going to equal the v naught x times the square root of 2 delta y over g. And that's what I've written here. Now, we're going to continue, but in a different clip, with the situation where v naught is at some angle A. You know, put an arrow over that vector. So that's where we're going to go next.